Hi everyone, I think I've designed one of the best soil sensors for Home Assistant, and I can't wait to hear your thoughts. The main goals are multi-sensor functionality, long range, long battery life, and easy configuration through a web page, plus it has a few more tricks up its sleeve. This video is sponsored by PCBWay, and two of you will get a soil sensor for free. To enter the giveaway, just subscribe and comment below. PCBWay is a leading manufacturer offering PCB prototyping, assembly, 3D printing, and more. They can even take your ideas and bring your vision to life. With fast turnaround times and excellent quality, whether you're a hobbyist or a professional, PCBWay provides reliable services to support your electronics projects. During the development stage, I decided to include the maximum number of sensors that would be helpful for plant care. So I added an ambient light sensor, even though the area under the plant doesn't get much light. A humidity and air temperature sensor wouldn't hurt either. And there's one more thing you don't see on other soil sensors, a soil temperature sensor. After a few days of working on the PCB design, this is what I've got. What do you think? This time, I ordered panelized boards, and they turned out amazing. Surprisingly, it worked. So let me show you the advantages and capabilities of this sensor. The board is a four-layer design, with capacitive sensor electrodes in the inner two layers, which protects the sensor from scratches and oxidation. Under this epoxy resin blob is the soil temperature sensor, with signal traces on the inside layers as well. Basically, as long as you don't hammer the sensor into a rock, it'll be just fine. This little component is the ambient light sensor, and this square one is the air temperature and humidity sensor. If you decide to apply a conformal coating, make sure not to cover the air sensor hole. And of course, no miracles for me. I found a mistake on the board, but I've already fixed it in the files, so don't pay attention to this wire. The trig button is designed to activate the sensor. When pressed briefly, the sensor will turn on, send the data, and then turn off again. The prog and reset buttons are for programming, but you don't need to reprogram the sensor. It comes ready to use. The calibration button is for soil moisture calibration and for entering the settings mode. The 250 mAh battery is located on the back side, and beneath it are PCB solder jumpers used for the wake-up cycle timer, which is set to 1 hour by default. I have one surprise for you guys. I also designed a wired version on a two-layer PCB. It works with both 3.3 volts and 5 volts, but remember, the output voltage depends on the supply voltage. I applied conformal coating to the components area and also designed a protective case, which I printed with ABS plastic. Another good option to protect the components is to use a heat shrink tube with heat activated glue inside. I'll be selling a couple dozen of these kits in my shop, but all the files are available for self-assembly. To configure the sensor, you'll need to put it into configuration mode. Detailed instructions are available on GitHub. The sensor supports two modes, ESP Now and Wi-Fi. In ESP Now mode, the sensor works with CapiBridge, video in the description. The only required configuration is the gateway key and sensor name. The advantages of this mode are much greater range than Wi-Fi and improved power efficiency. In Wi-Fi mode, you need to enter the sensor name, MQTT server, and Wi-Fi credentials. The advantages of this mode are that no gateway is needed, and autonomy is still good. After setting up, the soil moisture sensor needs to be calibrated. Without this step, the sensor will always show zero. For calibration, you need two types of soil, one dry and another at the maximum moisture level your plant can handle. This ensures the sensor is accurately calibrated for your plant's needs. First, place the sensor in dry soil and enter calibration mode. The sensor will start minimum calibration, indicated by the LED blinking twice. When the minimum calibration is complete, the LED will blink three times. After that, you'll have 10 seconds to place the sensor in wet soil. Once this period passes, the sensor will start the maximum value calibration. When finished, it will automatically shut down. Many might think the battery is too small for an ESP-based device. So let's measure the power consumption to calculate the autonomy in days. In ESP Now mode, the active phase lasts 550 milliseconds with an average current draw of 40 milliamps, while the inactive phase current draw is just 67 nanoamps. In Wi-Fi mode, the active phase lasts 1.5 seconds with an average current draw of 47 milliamps, while the inactive phase current draw remains the same at 67 nanoamps. Based on the measurements, the theoretical autonomy in Wi-Fi mode is nearly 1.5 years, while in ESP Now mode, it's around 4.5 years. If everything is set up correctly, you should see the new device in the MQTT device list. By default, it's called SoilSense V5W, which exposes humidity, light, moisture, two temperature sensors, and of course, battery percentage. The bottom part of the case will be glued to the PCB, and I will include two printed caps in the kit. One made with ASA plastic, which doesn't degrade when exposed to sunlight, and a translucent one printed with PETG for low light situations. Printing the cap with colored plastic doesn't make sense, because light can't pass through, meaning the light sensor won't work. And one more thing, if you plan to use it outdoors, you'll need to add extra rain protection. Thanks to BambuLab for providing the X1 Carbon 3D printer with an AMS unit. Prototyping with different materials is a breeze on this printer. It has a good-sized bed and prints at blazing speeds while keeping excellent quality. It's my third printer, but because of the amazing print quality, it feels like my first real 3D printer. I liked it so much that I ordered two more. And the best part? You can easily integrate it with Home Assistant. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and found the project useful. Please consider subscribing, and I'll see you next time.